Established in the fall of 2004, the Minor in International Migration Studies at UCSD is the first of its kind offered at any U.S. university. Undergraduate students will get an in-depth understanding of the causes, politics, social, and economic consequences of international migration in migrant sending and receiving countries around the world. With the minor, there are three tracks to choose from: field research, internship track, or coursework track. As part of a team of U.S. and Mexican students, UCSD students proficient in Spanish will have the opportunity to do field research in a rural Mexican community that sends migrants to the United States. Students do an academic internship in the San Diego, Tijuana area organization or public agency that provides services to immigrants and refugees. Involves taking a total of 7 courses, lower and upper division, from an approved list, up to 3 of which can be taken through study abroad.
I personally had experiences in Latin America previously to coming to UCSD, and I saw some migration, the people and their sufferings firsthand, and so I decided pretty early on that migration was something I wanted to get into. And I have a general interest in social work, so I thought this would be a good track.
For me, the primary incentive was the free trip that you got out of the whole research experience. And then later on I learned that it was pretty rewarding, and so I decided to go on it again, and then I'm going again on it. We start by identifying the town that we're going to study. We learn about it, and then we create a questionnaire that answers questions that are specific to the town and that are specific to what we need to know here in the United States, because in the end we want the research to somehow influence the policy that's being created. Then we go to the site and we interview door to door every person in the town. And then once we have all of those interviews, we put the data together and we create statistics, and we have after we have all of this knowledge base, we start creating a chapter.
We split into small groups to write our individual chapters. Now, each of these chapters is on a particular subject. So within the interest of migration, you also have the opportunity to tap into a second interest. And it's a composite of 9 or 10 different chapters written by 4 or 5 people. And that's the culmination of this book.
So we come up with this well-rounded book of specific examples of migrants.
Students, undergraduates and graduates, participating together, have a hand from the foundation, the first brick laid, until the final product. We help create the questionnaire, we find the research materials, we execute the interviews, we create the graphs and study the statistics, and then we write the book. And that's really rewarding to have as an undergraduate, as a 20-year-old coming in, to be able to participate in every step of the process. In the program, we've had the experience to one, study in a professional setting, but to also involve ourselves at a more personal level.
We get to go back into the town during the fiestas. There's a beauty pageant, there's all of the food from the town, there are carnival rides. It's really fun to go back and take part and connect with the people that are helping you during the daytime. This past year we got to go to Oklahoma City, and it was very rewarding to bring back some of the memories of Mexico to these people who haven't seen their family in 4 or 5 years, and you show them pictures and they're like, oh, that's my daughter, I haven't seen her in so long. And just to see the gap that this border enforcement is creating within the lives of these communities that are living here and there and not really in either, because they're so restricted by the laws that we're imposing.
I interviewed the father of a boy who had died in the desert, and he recounted the whole tale for me from start to when he went and picked up the body of his son and drove it back to their town for burial. And for me, that was the moment when my heart just became forever connected to this issue, because that was one story, and there are thousands and thousands of other stories like that.
We came back, and there was this couple that lives in Union City, and they emailed us, and they contacted us through Facebook and through MySpace, letting us know how thankful they were that we had interest in their town. I always wanted to find out a bit more about this key player in the shadows, which is the Goyot, the human smuggler. And I got to do that through applying for a grant here at UCSD, and I got the grant and I got to do the research, and then Professor Cornelius, the director of the program, put me in contact with the producers of 60 Minutes, and now they're taking up the story on immigration.
This summer I got an internship for a migrants' rights economic development NGO in the Bay Area, and working with this NGO this summer made me very excited to get to the point where I'm beyond college, where I can jump into that and really start making a difference.
For more information about how to participate in the Minor in International Migration Studies, you can contact Professor Wayne Cornelius at the Center for Comparative Immigration Studies or Melanie Davidson, Academic Counselor at Eleanor Roosevelt College. Students can get more information online by visiting roosevelt.ucsd.edu or by searching on Facebook for the International Migration Studies Group.